Your teeth in your soul and have to be rude. Call me time, I don't know. Man, I'm pushing the game and the vice is blue. Call me time, I don't know. Man, I'm pushing the road for the sailing crew. Call me time, I don't know. And man, stand by your side, girl, you got the juice. Call me time, I don't know. Call me time, I don't know. Call me time, I don't know. No, no. Tell me something I don't know. Tell me something I don't know. No, no. Tell me something I don't know. Tell me something I don't know. Yo, tell me something I don't know. Tell me Dexter Hastings here for BBColumn.com. I'm at Frankie Gavin's gym with Brad Thomas, just turned professional boxer. Yes. Brad, welcome to Fight Then, mate.
Thank you, brother. How are you?
I'm good.
Good.
Right, Brad, well, you come from the unlicensed scene.
Yeah, man.
Right, I've watched you a few times. You even won one of the BBColumn Challenge belt titles.
The only belt out there.
Yeah, very true. The one that counts in the unlicensed game.
Yes.
You won that. When we talked last time, you were turning pro then. That was a good year ago at least.
Yeah, what it was. Basically, I took another fight on with a very talented guy called John Hick. And even whilst I was training, I injured my long lead bicep tendon in my shoulder. I tried to work around it, but it was just getting worse and worse and worse. So I was told if I carry on, it's going to snap. I had to stop training, put on loads of weight. I went up to about 13, just over 13 stone. And I fought at 63.5 kilos,
okay.
So I put on a hell of a lot of weight. I was depressed, I was down, and then when they stopped, finally healed up and I could do what I love doing, boxing, I come back to the gym, and Frankie got my head screwed on, and I've been grinding ever since. And then people come to have a little look at me. I had an 8-round fight with Ant Phillips a couple of weeks ago now, done well, won all 8 rounds, boxed really well, and then got the opportunity to go pro. So hopefully my debut will be in mid-September. Which I'm training hard for, as you can see, with a red face.
is that the same time as Frankie's having his
same trainer? Same show as Frankie. I'll be on the undercard to that, so it's an honour to be on the same card as such a talented boxer. But so I think I'll be starting the show off. But I don't mind. Get out there, do a number on someone, and then the career starts. Then hopefully.
So my question to you is like. There's a lot of things you have to go through to become a professional boxer.
Yes,
right?
Yes.
How have you gone through that transition?
Frankie mentioned to the guys who signed him, BCB, Black Country Boxing, that there's a lad at his gym that trains hard like a pro and he's been interested in turning pro. So they come down and had a little look, and Malcolm Malvin, our trainer now, he's took me on the pads and a few words were said, and they asked me to go for a meeting up there, and then they threw a contract in front of me, said we want you to... as long as you pass all the tests and medical and the boxing assessments and stuff like that, then we're happy to sign you and turn you over. So that's what's gone through. I've done all my medicals now, brain scan, blood tests, my boxing assessments. The British Boxing Board of Control had a look at my fight, my white collar fight, and then they said you're happy to give me a license as long as I pass all the medical side of it. So I'm just waiting on that now, but I'm A1 fit, so I'm pretty confident that I'll go through.
I'm taking it. It was when you won the challenge belt that they thought, yeah.
Probably. They've probably seen someone's got that Birmingham boxing column belt. So yeah, we got to sign him soon. Phone call started ringing.
Lot of props with that, mate.
Yeah.
So are you looking forward to your debut?
Of course. I'm training so hard. For every fight, I've always trained hard. But being trained by a professional coach now, Malcolm Malvin. Honestly, the man is an animal, and he's going to turn me into an animal. I thought I was fit. As it was, the level I get to, but this is just taking it to a different league. So I'm taking it in my stride. I'm working hard. I'm eating right, and I'm never missing a session. Training twice a day. My fitness is good. Doing high intensity runs in the morning. I'm getting ready for a 4-round fight. I used to do these hour runs, the 10-mile runs, but he's saying to me now I need to get ready for a 4-round fight. I need to be explosive for 4 rounds. Yeah. So we've took the running down, doing 30 minutes high intensity in the morning, and then I'm back in here in the afternoon having a hard, tough boxing session with Malk. Hopefully I've got a couple of little injuries at the moment, but once they're all done, Malcolm's going to start me sparring and see where I'm at. But I'm very confident, man. I feel good.
Now, do you know what? Every time we've seen you box, you look confident, it was obvious. From a long time back that you were going to turn pro.
Oh, I appreciate that, man.
And that's serious, that's a few times. I think I've even refed you a few times.
Yeah, probably, yeah. We got way back that way.
Yeah, it should not be in.
White
collar ring.
Yeah.
Is there anything you want to say to the people who have followed you and any sponsors?
Honestly, Roy. The nights where I fight and I get great support. I've always got great support, 100 plus people every single time, and I can't even describe to you how much it means. Honestly, the feeling you get, especially when you get that win, and looking at all my friends and my family, it means the world. And yeah, going forward, sponsors to help me out. The start of your career is always hard. So anyone want to come in, I've got a good following. Anyone wants to come in and help out with my career, then just get in touch. Brad Thomas on Facebook or BradThomas030992 on Instagram. Get in touch and we'll get something sorted. But watch this space. I'm going to graft and graft and graft and see where I'll go.
Everyone, Brad Thomas.
Yes, Dex, much respect. Thank you.
Great catching up with Brad today. BB Cobham, Challenge Belt winner when he was in the unlicensed scene. Making his pro debut. It's a long time coming because I talked to him last year when he was supposed to be doing it. But injuries now, all clear. He's one of them characters that you really want to do well because he's just a nice bloke, you know what I mean? And if he wins a British title, you know what? He won one of more Challenge Belts, which can't be bad, can he? Looking forward to seeing Brad fight. He's fighting on the 16th of September as well. He couldn't announce it properly, but the BCB have told me that I can tell everyone. 16th of September, Holiday Inn, undercard of Frankie Gavin. You know what I mean? Going to be a great night of boxing.
Tell me something I don't know. Yo, tell me something I don't know.